the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
And then we're not both seeing that. Ibo ko si Bishop Pavilion. Pero igutusan ko, at siguro ito yung penalty pag ikaw ay na-late. Kapag na-late ako. We offer this Mass, gratitude, celebration of God's love. We pray that God will enlighten our minds, our hearts, our souls, so that once more we may grow to love Him and serve Him. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, let us feel your compassion more readily during these days, when by your gift we have known it more fully, so that those who have freed from the darkness of error may cling more firmly to the teachings of your truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Look, there is water. What is to prevent me by being baptized? A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The angel of the Lord spoke to Philip, "Get up and head south on the road that goes down from Jerusalem to Gaza, the desert route." So he got up and set out. Now there was an Ethiopian eunuch, a court official of the Candace, that is, the queen of the Ethiopians, in charge of her entire treasury, who had come to Jerusalem to worship and was returning home. Seated in his chariots, he was reading the prophet Isaiah. The Spirit said to Philip, "Go and join up with the chariots." Philip ran up and heard him reading Isaiah the prophet and said, "Do you understand what you are reading?" He replied, "How can I, unless someone instructs me?" So he invited Philip to get in and sit with him. This was the scripture passage he was reading. Like a sheep, he was led to the slaughter, and as a lamb before its shearer is silent, so he opened not his mouth. In his humiliation, justice was denied him. He will tell of his prosperity, for his life is taken from the earth. Then the eunuch said to Philip in reply, "I beg you, about whom is the prophet saying this? About himself or about someone else?" Then Philip opened his mouth, and beginning with the scripture passage, he proclaimed Jesus to him. As they traveled along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, "Look, there is water. What is to prevent my being baptized?" Then he ordered the carriage to stop, and Philip and the eunuch both went down into the water, and he baptized him. Then they came out of the water. The Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away, and the eunuch saw him no more, but continued in his way, rejoicing. Philip came to Azotus and went about preaching the good news to all the towns until he reached Caesarea. the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let all the earth cry out to God in joy.
Let all the earth cry out to God in joy.
Blessed are God, you peoples. Loudly sound his praise. He has given life to our souls. He has not let our feet slip.
Let all the earth cry out to God in joy.
Hear now, all you hear, hear God, while I declare what he has done for me. When I appealed to him in words, praise was on the tip of my tongue.
Let all the earth cry out to God in joy.
Blessed be God, who refused me not, my prayer for this kindness.
Let all the earth cry out to God in joy.
I was forced to because I was inside the taxi. And
hear someone speaking with so much conviction about their belief na itaan. Siya na yun? Anyway, sariyana pa na yun. Okay, anyway. He was quoting some Bible verses. So, obviously, I could sense that the what they were quoting, these verses, were out of context. And there was really no meaning. That the spirit of their preaching is not to give life, to give love, to teach or guide the people, but actually just to prove that they are the one religion. And so, I've also experienced joining the board again, etc. And it's a different experience also. But what I do love to do whenever given the chance is that I watch EWTN. And one of my favorite programs there is The Journey Home. I believe that I have a good amount of faith at a young age because with the help of my parents, with the help of the grace of God, I have much great faith in my religion, my faith, in the Catholic faith. But it's one thing to learn the faith, and it's another thing to be affirmed of your faith. And whenever I watch The Journey Home, the faith that I have is strengthened, is affirmed. And why? Because during the program of The Journey Home, these pastors come from different Protestant sects. Oftentimes, these are practically the leaders of their faith. They who say that they have studied all their life the Bible, practically fundamentalists. And then they would share the reason why they would go back to the Catholic Church. They would go back home to the Catholic Church. And let me share you two or three examples. The most important, I guess, is the first one. This fundamentalist practically has memorized the Bible from the beginning to the end. And when he came to today's gospel, believe it or not, it is today's gospel that converted him, or that changed his heart. He would read the Old Testament and look at the prophecies of the prophets, speaking about the coming of the Messiah, speaking of the deliverance from sin. And he would always notice that the New Testament would be a fulfillment of the Old Testament, and that this fulfillment would bring true peace, true joy, true love, true meaning, true fulfillment in the lives of the people. And in today's gospel, when Jesus tells us, "I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever partakes of me will have their sins will be forgiven. They will have life everlasting. The bread that I give is my flesh, for the life of the world." When it comes to this part, I remember he would tell the host, this part here, oftentimes our sect believes that this is symbolic, that whoever listens to God receives the truth, and in their faith they will be saved. But looking through the whole of the Bible, you would say, why would Jesus end the prophecy with a symbolism, with a mere figure of speech? He was not saying, "I am merely the bread of life." What Jesus was talking about was true bread. What Jesus was talking about was true flesh. Whoever partakes of me receives me. The bread becomes the true body. The wine becomes the true blood of Christ. It is the sacrament. But as mentioned yesterday, we enter into the space of God whenever we celebrate the sacrament of the Eucharist. Jesus sacrifices his love, his body, his blood for each and every one of us. Not merely for the salvation of those 2,000 years ago, but for every person who partakes of his body and his blood. And if this is the point where he believes that only in the Catholic Church do we realize the fulfillment of God's promise in the sacraments. In the first reading, we see the importance of baptism, that baptism is here for everyone who have faith to become a child of God. This is, many have been converted because of the sacrament of the Eucharist. Another example I would give you is an agnostic, a person who believes in God and doesn't really commit himself to one religion, but he always reads the Bible. But he doesn't want to say, I'm a Catholic, I'm a Protestant, etc. And then one thing changed his heart to embrace the Catholic faith. For many years, he has been living with his wife. He loves his wife, but they are just partners. And then one time, they had a crisis in the relationship, and he would ask himself, what is happening? Where am I going? He had a crisis in faith. Then he would go back to the scriptures and read, whatever God has bound, no one must separate. What God has bound, no one must separate. It speaks about faithfulness. It speaks about a love that was meant to be forever. But more importantly, it speaks about God, who is capable of binding two people together, man and woman, two who become one in the sacrament of matrimony. And it is because of this that he embraces the Catholic faith. Two sacraments, three sacraments that bring out that all that Jesus has been promising, all that God has been promising and has fulfilled, finally finds its fruitfulness in the sacraments. And it is here for us to receive God's presence, God's love, God's blessing. And my dear brothers and sisters, truly, God has loved us with an eternal love. Nothing can separate us from the love of Christ. May we receive the sacraments with a heart open, acknowledging that God truly accepts us, forgives us, believes in us, and loves us. He comes to save us. He comes to strengthen us. He comes to give us guidance. He comes to give us meaning in life. God has sacrificed so much in order to give us his wisdom. God has sacrificed so much to give us his love, to give us his body, his blood. And so we see in the sacraments the joy of Christ's resurrection. That in the sacraments God is truly alive and his spirit is working in so many ways, a power that death cannot destroy, hatred cannot destroy, sin cannot destroy. It is through sacraments that we are saved. With our faith in God, with our love for him, God gives us what we need in order to be with him. We thank God for this gift, and we pray that we will be able to share it to our students, to let them appreciate the sacraments more and more to deepen their understanding that God is truly with them and His love and grace will be with us forever. Turn now in prayer to God the Father, who from the generosity of His heart has sent His Son Jesus, the bread of life. For every prayer we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let the people of God, now we shall be in Christ, be united to persevere in the lives of faith and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That's what the words say. Reception of the Eucharist. We may deepen our love for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may not fail to share our earthly bread with those who need so come life of Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.